Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 2.5, Problem 1. This is problem number 1 from Section 2.5. It says find the inverse of the matrix, and it's a smaller matrix. The top row is 1, 2, and the bottom row is 2, 3. All the entries are positive. So, to find the inverse, we're going to write the matrix that we have to find the inverse of, and right next to it, we're going to write an identity matrix of the same size. So what we're going to wind up with is a big double-wide matrix. The top row of this double-wide matrix is 1, 2, 1, 0, and the second row is 2, 3, 0, 1. Now, what we have to do is whatever steps are required to solve the matrix on the left, in other words, make it look like an identity, and as we do those steps, apply it to the entire double-width matrix, and the matrix on the right will turn into the inverse of the one we started with. So, to solve the matrix on the left, the position in the upper leftmost spot has to become a 1. Now, just by coincidence, it already is a 1, so that's good. Next, the number underneath that 1 in the upper leftmost position must turn into a 0. And right now it's a 2, so we do have to do some work. It's a 2, we're going to turn it into a 0. So when we do that, the top row can stay the same. That won't change. It will stay 1, 2, 1, 0, big long row. And underneath, to turn a 2 into a 0, we're going to make a new row 2, and it's going to equal some stuff plus the old row 2, just like when we solve a matrix. It starts with row 2 because that's the row we're making a 0 in. It ends with row 2 because the beginning and end should be the same when we write those equations. Now, what I left as stuff should be the row with the pivot position, which is row 1, times the same number opposite sign as what's becoming a 0. And what's becoming a 0 is a positive 2. So it's going to be times negative 2. So the equation we're going to use to make our new row 2 is row 2 equals negative 2 times row 1 plus the old row 2. Now as we do that, in the first column, the negative 2 times 1 will make a negative 2. We're going to add that to row 2, so we're going to add to positive 2, so we get the 0 that we need to have. But we need to apply that equation to every value in the bottom row. So the next column over, we're going to do negative 2 times row 1. That'll make negative 2 times 2, which is negative 4. Add that result to row 2. So we're going to do negative 4 plus positive 3, which is negative 1. And then we have to apply the equation again to the values in the third column. So negative 2 times row 1 is negative 2 times 1. That'll be negative 2 plus row 2. So negative 2 plus 0. So that's minus 2. And finally, the fourth column. Negative 2 times row 1 is negative 2 times 0, which is 0, plus row 2, so plus 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So that step is complete. So the far left column, we got the 1 first, we had it anyway, then we made the 0. So we're going to move over one column to the right, make the 1 first, and then 0 the rest of the column. So the next column over, the 1 has to be in the bottom position. And right now it's a negative 1. So to make a 1, we're going to multiply the whole bottom row times 1 over minus 1. So when we do that, the top row will stay the same. So the top row is 1, 2, 1, 0. And I'm going to make a new bottom row, which I'll use the equation row 2 equals 1 over minus 1 times the old row 2, which can really be just negative 1 times row 2. So every value in row 2 is going to be multiplied times negative 1, and that will make the positive 1 show up where it needs to be in that bottom right position. So as I go across row 2, every value times negative 1, first I have to do negative 1 times 0, which is 0. Then negative 1 times negative 1, which is positive 1. Then negative 1 times negative 2, which is positive 2. And then negative 1 times 1, which is negative 1. So now, we have to zero out the rest of that second column. We made the 1 where it needs to be, and now the remaining number in the second column is a 2. It has to become a 0. It's in the top row, so I'm going to make a new top row. And to 0 a 2, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put row 1 equals some stuff plus the old row 1. So again, I'm starting in row 1 because that's the row where I have to make the 0 in. I'm ending in row 1 because the equations should begin and end with the same thing. Now, what I left is stuff. It should be the row at the pivot point, which is row 2 at this step, times the same number, but opposite sign is what's becoming a 0. What's becoming a 0 is a positive 2, so same number, opposite sign is negative 2. So the equation I'm going to use to make a new row 1 is row 1 equals negative 2 times row 2 plus row 1. And we're going to apply that to every number in row 1. So in the first column, we'll do negative 2 times row 2 will be negative 2 times 0, which is 0. That result plus row 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1. The next column over, negative 2 times row 2 is negative 2 times 1, which makes a minus 2. And we're going to add that to row 1. So we'll have minus 2 plus positive 2 is 0. And then we're going to go over the next column. Negative 2 times row 2 is negative 2 times 2, which is minus 4. That minus 4 plus row 1. So you're going to have minus 4 plus positive 1 is negative 3. Again, pay attention to your signs. And now the last column, you're going to do negative 2 times row 2. So negative 2 times negative 1 is positive 2 plus row 1. So that positive 2 plus row 1 is positive 2 plus 0. So positive 2 plus 0 is just 2. And the bottom row can stay the way it is. It is 0, 1, 2, negative 1. So now the matrix on the left half of my double wide matrix now looks like an identity matrix. It's 1, 0, 0, 1. The matrix on the right half of my double wide matrix has become the identity, I mean the inverse, rather, of the matrix that we started with. So A inverse is the matrix on the right half of my double wide matrix, which is negative 3, positive 2 in the top row, and 2, negative 1 in the bottom row. That's the inverse, like that. And the notation looks like A to the negative 1 power. It's read A inverse.